Yeah, this should be working just fine now. Okay, right. Well, I guess I'll do a little intro, and then we'll get on with whatever it is you'd like to talk about. We'll let this be your day. I'll just say hello. Hello, I'm Jim Sterling. Many of you all know me from videos what I do on this channel, what you're presumably watching it on now. Unless Digital Homicide wants to host it on their website, they're more than welcome to do so. I'm here with Digital Homicide themselves. Hello.
Hello, this is Robert.
This is Robert. Hello, Robert. I am, first of all, somewhat relieved that I'm hearing the voice of an adult man. I was expecting to not hear the voice of an adult, so this makes me feel a little bit better about things.
Oh, yeah. And I have three kids. I'm 35. I'm definitely an adult.
Oh, dear. Okay, then. You requested this interview, I guess we can call it an interview, after today's video where I covered medieval mercs. That's presumably short for mercenaries. And you seem quite eager to have a free-form discussion about things.
Oh, yeah, absolutely, because every time that you do a video, it's always a one-sided conversation. And your audience comes and attacks me based on your one-sided conversation. So I wanted to make sure that we can talk and get both sides of everything so everybody knows.
No, I mean, I fully agree with you there. It's really been two different one-sided conversations because, as you quite correctly point out, when I do a video on a Digital Homicide game, it is a very one-sided issue because I'm just speaking directly to my audience. And then when you go on the Steam forums for your games, you are talking to your...
No, I'm talking to your audience, too, because your audience comes to my forums and attacks me on a regular basis.
Right,
I'm not talking to just my audience. I'm talking to yours because I have to deal with your audience every single day.
And my main question would be, with that issue there, is can your audience... let me rephrase that question. Does your audience, outside of my audience, exist?
Oh, yeah, totally. There is people that enjoy our games. You might be surprised at the amount of games that we have sold. You'd be surprised that there's actually people that defend against the people that come and attack and spout off your nonsense. Let's talk specifically about your nonsense. Just go ahead and start all the way back at the beginning and go ahead and ramble off all your accusations and stuff, and I will address every one of your issues specifically, step by step. Start from the beginning, the first thing, whatever you want.
Okay. When we say right back from the beginning, are we talking specifically about the slaughtering grounds?
Sure, we can talk about the slaughtering grounds.
Okay. Now, was that your very first foray into creating a game?
Second game.
That was your second game. What was your first?
The first one was Forsaken Uprising.
Ah, yes, I do recall.
How long have you been doing videos?
How long have I been doing videos?
Yes, let's just give some perspective. How long have you been doing videos? This is what you do for a living, correct?
That's absolutely
okay,
correct.
Okay, so you've been probably doing this for what, I'm guessing 10 years, maybe, videos?
Not videos specifically. I've mostly, for most of my career, I've been a writer, and I've been writing for, let's say, professionally within the realm of games, about 8 years.
Okay, so how long have you been doing videos?
How long have I been doing videos?
5 years?
Be generous and say five? Let's say five.
Okay, so you've been making videos for 5 years. Were your first videos absolutely professional quality?
Absolutely not.
Okay, thank you. All right,
because YouTube channel that I wasn't charging money for.
Have you taken those videos off of your YouTube channel? Are they still available for people to watch? Because you have advertising revenue being generated from those unprofessionally done videos, then. Correct?
No, because
there's no ad revenue being generated from those.
They might be generated for somebody, but not me. I was experimenting. Destructoid, when I first started working, Destructoid was doing very experimental stuff. And just kind of, they had to kind of throw any odd shit up and see what sticks. It was all kind of, because it was free of charge and everything.
But you did make money off of that, because you worked for Destructoid, so you did earn your salary from Destructoid, or however they paid you. So in some form or manner, you were paid for those unprofessional products, were you not?
That's actually not true. I was paid a salary for my reviews work. I worked as reviews editor for Destructoid for several years, and that's what I was paid for.
You just said that you did it for Destructoid.
Destructoid is an independent website, and at the time, wasn't making a huge deal of money. And they were trying to get video production off the ground. All of the videos I did for them was pro bono.
All of the video work you did for them was pro bono?
Yes, yes.
But you just associated it to Destructoid, as in, well, that was my reasoning, is I did it under Destructoid, so it's not associated.
No, no, what I'm saying is you asked if I got ad revenue for those videos, which I don't and didn't. But only when the videos reached a level of quality I was happy with, did I then move the Jimquisition to the Escapist, where I signed professional contracts and actually made money off it. And have continued to, in the face of criticism, which, you know, I get just as much as you, continue to evolve and improve the product over many, many years by listening to feedback, not, say, censoring comments, not banning people from forums that have problems with the work at hand. No matter how innocuous, because let's face it, even the innocuous stuff gets banned on a digital homicide game forum.
No. Hey, wait. We can totally address the whole banning thing. Like, for instance, when you said that I ran a contest during Slaughtering Grounds, and that I was just indiscriminately banning people, which is a total lie. We can bring up a Steam moderator. One of your people went and posted on the Steam community forums, and the moderator locked his thread and told him, no, he is totally following his rules and guidelines for the contest. If they could talk all the trash they wanted. There was very few people banned. I gave 3 keys away to the people who talked the most trash in that. But this goes along with everything else that you do. You spout a whole bunch of unalleged facts, things that you conject as being fact. Let's talk about today. What about your video today? Your headline for that video, nothing in it was true. Your time frame in... In a year and a half, Digital Homicide has put out 4 games. You didn't get the time frame correct? We have 5 games. This shows the level of commitment you do to your stuff. You just don't investigate anything and just spout out information and hopefully somebody will believe it, which you've quoted in your videos, saying that people will believe anything that you say as long as you do it artistically. It doesn't matter if what you say is true. You just throw it out there, and people gobble it up.
I'll cop to that mistake. I'm a man who cops to his mistakes. You're absolutely right. You've done 5 videos, 6 including 6 Nights at Susie's.
When have I not?
Obviously didn't go up.
You're saying that I don't cop to my stuff. So
in an unscripted environment, obviously mistakes get made, and I do cop to those mistakes when they are made. The main problem with that is I was pointing out, and I wasn't saying that as a good thing, how many games you were doing, I was actually pointing out as a negative. So I'm more than happy to say that in a year and a half you've done 5 games. 4 sounds a bit better, to be honest. But if you'd like me to add that, I mean, I will certainly use annotations. You guys are just churning game after game out.
That is a great point. You make a great point. Let's talk about churning stuff out. Let's talk about how many videos you about substandard products being delivered on a regular basis. What are your squirty plays? What is the definition of a squirty play? Your squirty plays are, I haven't done a whole lot of investigation into the game. Well, why don't you do a quality review instead of a squirty play? The reason is because you generate views from your squirty play. You put your squirty plays out there and snatch up a whole bunch of views for something that you did not invest a lot of time in. Is that an inaccurate description?
Well, the problem with
that... Is that an inaccurate description?
The problem with that allegation is you're assuming that that's all I do. I actually do fully fully written, fully researched reviews of many, many games.
I'm not saying you don't.
The play thing is something I do on the side, mostly for fun.
Exactly. And you're generating ad revenue off of that.
Absolutely. Quite a lot of it.
Thank you. Thank you for admitting that. So you make money off of half-done, low-effort stuff. Thank you for admitting that.
I do. When it comes to covering your videos, I'm making money off of low-effort stuff.
Well, now you're just insulting rather than just trying to actually have a point.
Well, before we started this interview, you called me a chicken shit, so I think...
Well, you really were being a chicken shit.
Throwing stones in a glass house, sir.
You totally were being a chicken shit. We're getting off of the topic, though. Keep going with other things that you say that I've done.
Okay. Let's go with the Slaughtering Games, because, as I said, for Forsaken Uprising, I didn't think it was that bad. A bit boring, but... As far as some of your games go, quite well made, in context. So, we don't have to cover that one too much unless there's anything you'd like to say about it. But I always felt I was, kinder to that one because I felt like you'd put some effort into it, if that's fair to say.
I honestly think it was just a little more complicated since it's a survival game, and you really lack in the department of actually playing complicated games.
Touché. Touché. I mean, you know, I'm a huge fan of Bloodborne and all of the Souls games, of which I really don't think your games are comparable in the least.
I never said I was a AAA developer.
No one did.
You know, you can throw your insults, but I have never stated...
Insult, that was a statement of fact.
Well, it's nice you finally do one a fact.
Okay, if we're going to say that's the first fact of the interview, fine. Here's another one. If we're going to focus on the Slaughtering Grounds to begin with, you did take offense at me, you know, not putting the effort into covering your game, but a lot of people in the aftermath seem to think you didn't put any effort in yourselves. For example, the blood spatter that shows damage on the game, that seems to have been ripped from Google Images to the point where all of the artifacts from the, I'm assuming you used PNG images, are still visible. I'm looking at a screenshot right now that shows the blood spatter on Google Images versus the blood spatter shown in the Slaughtering Grounds, where they are covered in artifacts where you didn't remove the background from the blood properly.
Yeah, that's a good point. Back then, I was new to stuff. Just follow me for a second, bear with me.
Sure.
So I was new. I didn't realize there was no copyright on the image. I didn't realize it was an issue. As of today, that image has been removed. What brings up a question is do you have a license for all of the things you use in your video? Your songs, your images of costumes, all of that artwork? Do you have licenses for that stuff?
I have licenses for the stuff that is tied into the actual branding, and everything else is fair use, as I think you found out when you tried to hit me with a copyright strike for the Slaughtering Grounds.
Oh, yeah, let's talk about that, since you bring it up. You seem to
please.
Let's talk about DMCA. So, you've heard, I'm sure, about Nintendo and Sega, and they've had successful lawsuits in claiming their content?
No, they haven't.
They haven't had any success.
Well, they've not had any... none of this stuff has ever been taken to court, so they've not had any successful lawsuits, no.
Oh, the content that hasn't been claimed on YouTube. They have not claimed that content.
You're asking a different question.
Yes.
They've been able to use Content ID, which is something...
And claim their content.
...I very rarely fight.
And claim their content.
Because that is a different issue from a takedown strike. These are two very... Because you've demonstrated as something of a muddled understanding of the law in your posts on this issue. All
that's
of which
the
I
whole
say,
point.
Just in case they ever went to court.
You guys, Total Biscuit, everybody, insist that we have no right to claim our content. We have I'm so glad you're talking about this. We have every right to claim our content. The reason that there's an issue is that the law is gray. What I would like to point out is take your video, right?
Yeah.
Take my gameplay out of your video. And
it's
let's see.
It's your gameplay. It's your game, but it's my gameplay in common terms.
Take.
That's what we call transformative work. Are you familiar with the concept of transformative
work? Is that
work?
What they do with movies? I don't really think I've seen a live critique of a movie showing all of the movie.
with all due respect, outside of the work of David Cage, most video games are actually a completely different medium from movies. It's actually a totally different medium that allows for transformative works. For example, you know, competitive gameplay, Twitch streaming. There's enough input from the player, which is why there's this grey area here as opposed to movies.
If it's so grey, then how have they successfully content claimed it?
Right, but again, this is a different issue. They
how have they content claimed their stuff?
Well, my question to you is, if it's so black and white, how come you've not content ID'd my videos?
Because, just like every other one of the small developers that you shit on a regular basis, we don't have the funds to take you to court. It's not right, that we don't think we'll win.
Content ID is not a court issue. Do you understand the difference between content ID and an actual takedown strike?
If we have contacted and asked for a content, and they say that we should contact their legal department. So it must be a legal issue if YouTube is telling us that it is one.
Well, my confusion there is you were so confident that you would take me to court. Like, you actually said you were going to do this. You said,
and then we realized how much it would cost.
Were made for this issue, you would see me in a court of law.
I know.
And I waited and waited for this.
I'm sure you did. What the problem is that although
I've got a folder of evidence to, like, absolutely demolish you in a court of law.
We have 17 pages of stuff. So don't worry, we have plenty of evidence.
Well, where's the lawsuit?
Because we don't have the money. We don't make $10,000 a month on Patreon. I'm sorry. We have 5 video games, but as you've stated, they're low-quality video games, and we don't make that much money. We're these big, rich, evil developers. If you saw my income, you would be sad at what my income is. I definitely don't make $10,000 a month
by spewing crap on
other people.
But I see a lot of your stuff. But that's besides the point. The point is you were very gung-ho, and your reason for not taking me to court was that you had more important things to do. Not that you didn't have enough money, which is something I could have respected. My question is, why were you so confident and so brazen and I would say boastful that you were going to take me to court and hash this out? And finally do away with the grey area. This could have been a lawsuit that would have settled a lot of scores for a lot of people. You know, I had Total Biscuit and various other YouTubers telling me, like, if this goes through, this could be a definitive thing. You were so confident, and so I think the world was disappointed when you then brushed it off as you've got better things to do, you don't have time to deal with this.
It's not that we didn't...
is very different from the reason you're giving me now.
No. It's not that we don't have time to deal with it ever. We don't have time to deal with it right now because I'm trying to be successful and make a business. You make your money off making our business. I'm glad I got to that too. If everyone quits making games, does your job still exist if there's no games to review?
Well,
answer that question direct. Yes or no?
Absolutely no, yeah.
Okay,
you're absolutely right. If there are no video games, then video game critics and media don't... Sorry, I'm very confused by that point there.
I know, just follow with me. Okay, if that is the case...
Mm-hmm.
Just a sec. So, I've kind of lost my train of thought there.
That's alright. I'll give you a moment to get it back. You were saying how, if the entire video game industry disappeared...
Oh, yeah,
then
the back
I
and
wouldn't
forth.
Have a job. So, or at least this job.
No, that's not the case either. I totally don't
that's
mind...
What I said.
I totally don't mind YouTube reviewers. The problem is that YouTube reviewers habitually rely upon games. Game developers. Is that correct?
Again, to answer the question, I mean, you're just going to keep asking it? The answer to that question is, you're correct.
Okay,
yes.
So...
Someone who reviews video games can't review video games if video games don't exist.
Okay, the problem is that is the definition of a leech.
No, it isn't.
Absolutely it is. We can look it up on Google right now. Would you like to look up the definition of leech? Habitually rely upon. That is the definition of a leech. Habitually rely upon. Look it up. I've already looked it up.
Leech creatures are segmented worms that belong to the phylum Annelida. Sorry, hold on, let me pronounce that correctly. Annelida, and comprise the subclass Pyridinia. Like the oligopiatus, such as earthworms, leeches, serpray, slitilum, yeah, and are hermaphrodites, apparently.
Okay.
Nevertheless, they're different from
what
the
is the verb? What is the verb usage? Look, I'm looking right at it. Leech.
For example, leeches do not have bristles, and the external segmentation of their bodies does not correspond with the internal segmentation of their organs.
Okay, so leech, the
verb... We've learned a lot about leeches here.
Okay, habitually exploit or rely upon, especially the exploit part, because that's the difference. It's not that all leeches are bad. Leeches have medical purposes. Leeches are good for people. They have all kinds of benefits. The problem is the leeches that suck the blood out of their hosts until they wither and die. That's what you are.
Right, but now I'm looking at Merriam-Webster. Webster? Sorry, it's all that Latin stuff in the other description. Merriam-Webster, got it right there, says, let's see, any of numerous carnivorous or blood-sucking, usually freshwater annelid worms that have typically a flattened, lanceolate, segmented body with a sucker at each end.
Yeah, read the next one. I'm looking at the same thing. What's the next one say? It's very similar to the other definition. What is the third definition?
That's a hanger-on who seeks advantage or gain.
There you go. That is definitely a YouTube reviewer's description. And it's not that it's bad. You make it bad.
I personally make it bad.
Absolutely.
Right.
You stifle... Okay, I'm not saying any of our games are amazing, and I never have, but are my games getting better?
It's very up and down.
It is...
Forsaken Uprising was one of your strongest ones.
Then
Slaughtering Grounds came out and was one of the worst games of the year, as voted not just by me, but Pro Jared and Angry Joe. Then came out... what was the next one that came out? That would have been Deadly Prophets, was it not?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, that one, I liked. As I said before, that one was... Oh, I say light. I mean, it was relatively light. Then Temper Tantrum came out. That was fucking god-awful. And then Medieval Mercs, which, less said about that one, the better. So you've kind of had an arc. You started up. Went downhill dramatically.
But as usual...
It's just been a slope.
You don't even ask any questions. You just spout information that you don't know anything about. You don't know that Temper Tantrum was actually finished in December. You don't know that the order of which games were completed. Temper Tantrum sat in green light and was waiting to be. That's why its quality was lower than Deadly Prophets.
So you're saying, right, if we're going by my personal definition of which games are the better ones, you're saying that you develop the games in this order. And do, again, like, correct me if I'm wrong. Let's see, what was the worst one? That would be Temper Tantrum, Slaughtering Grounds, Medieval Mercs, Forsaken Uprising, and then Deadly Prophets. Am I correct? Is that the development order?
No. Those are all our games. The development order was Forsaken Uprising, Slaughtering Grounds, Temper Tantrum, and then Deadly Prophets, and now Medieval Mercs. Although Medieval Mercs was started right after Deadly Prophets.
Right. So it's not been a sliding scale upwards of quality, at least as far as I'm concerned. Now, obviously, tastes differ. But at this point, we're arguing pure difference of opinion.
Your opinion is that the games are not getting better?
My opinion is that, judging from the information you just gave me, you reshuffled the games, but it's still peaks and troughs.
Slaughtering Grounds and Temper Tantrum were before Deadly Prophets and Medieval Mercs. So these games are getting better.
So Medieval Mercs is shit.
Well, you didn't even play it at all. Did you know that there's a help menu? Did you even know there's a help menu?
To be honest, the sheer geographical chaos that was your menu system.
That's what just goes to show why you're a bad person, man.
A bad person?
Yes, you're terrible. You are terrible.
Right, okay.
You're not doing a critique. You are not doing a critique. What is a critique?
No, that's not what Squirty Play is.
That was a squirty play?
Yeah.
Where's the critique of it? Because from what we've been talking right now, I assumed you had already done your full critique.
No, that's the first...
Oh, that'll be the Jimquisition when you crap all over it again. Okay, at least I'll know when it's coming.
Oh, no. Your mentions on Jimquisition are...
often.
Very numbered.
I think I've won an award. You know, let's talk
I would say keep an eye on end of the year for more mentions of your games on the Jimquisition, sort of towards, around about awards season.
The Slaughtering Grounds forum, since we were talking about Slaughtering Grounds, at the very top of the Slaughtering Grounds forum, have you read the post that's been pinned there where I had a conversation with another reviewer? Probably not, because you don't follow up on any of your stuff. So, in that, I talk to another reviewer, and it's a lengthy thing for all of your people to go and read. There's tons of information. I even say that maybe my initial video, I didn't say maybe, my initial video was a little bit of an overreaction.
This would be the review the reviewer video you did, where you coined the phrase,
thank you for saying I coined it. Thank you for saying I coined that phrase.
I'm not saying you didn't coin that phrase. Everyone's thrilled you did, and I've got to say I'm thrilled as well.
I'm sure you are.
You coined the phrase Jim fucking Sterling, so.
Which is
I'm not taking that away from you.
Not only.
That's the best thing you've ever found in the game industry.
It just goes to show, out of this situation, the whole review the reviewer thing, where I made my video, then you did your thing, and kept attacking over and over, and all the people came, and it's been game after game after game, and my financial status has been hurt from what you do. How has your subscriber base done since that first video?
My subscriber base has basically been on a very consistent uptick ever since I started doing videos. That's talking before I ever touched your stuff. It's been a very, I get at least a couple of hundred subscribers, usually 1,000 new subscribers a day. That's mostly ever since I moved the Jimquisition from the Escapist to the channel, if you're hoping to claim any credit there.
So this hasn't helped you at all?
I'm not saying it hasn't helped. I mean, every single video I do helps.
So, again, what you do to me helps you and hurts me, right?
If you believe it hurts you, obviously I've not seen the evidence of your financial terms.
All you have to do is go to my forums and see the people that you have sending, coming to the forums all the time.
Same stuff.
Like, your lies about me banning people unfairly.
There's a correlation between my audience being upset with your behavior and you losing money, but as we all know, as every schoolboy knows, correlation is not causation. Where is the evidence that you are directly financially harmed by me? I mean, you said by your own admission, your games sell, pretty decently well, according to yourself.
Pretty decently well? I'm not going to give you the financial information because
I don't need the financial information.
Yeah, that's a confidential thing between me and Steam. We are finally, after the fifth game, at the point where I can take time to come and talk to you now because I'm not worried about my financial stablehood anymore. I put everything on the line in order to try and make games. And from the beginning, just like all these other small developers, this is what I was talking about earlier, my point where I was saying, my games are getting better. The problem is that these other indie developers that you crap on, they give up right off the bat because they get attacked by this huge horde. You stifle innovation. You think I'm joking? No, what? Go look at what you do to people. I'm glad you think what you do is... I'm glad you think ruining people's lives is funny.
Anything you've done.
I'm glad you think ruining people's lives is funny. Remember earlier when I said you were a terrible person? You just proved what I said. You think ruining people's lives is funny.
Right. My follow-up question to that is, do you really think that's gonna play?
What?
Do you really think me laughing at your hyperbole and you twisting it into me laughing at the financial ruination
of small
developers is going to play?
I did not twist any words. Play it back. There is no word twisting there. This is exactly your personality and persona that you put on all the time. You are the biggest hypocrite ever. You are a total hypocrite. Here's a hypocrite for you. You talk crap about Six Nights at Susie's for blah, 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 about abusing women, which I told him it should have been a male figure because I knew you were going to jump all over that crap. The very next video you do, you've got a 3-foot fucking dildo on your shoulder. Quit being such a hypocrite. See, and you think it's funny.
Again, I'm sorry. I apologize if I sound disrespectful. I'm just trying to pass the logic of your statement. I'm not sure what the weapon from Saints Row has to do with a game in which you're beating up the corpses of women.
You think that a 3-foot purple dildo on your shoulder is respectful to your women viewers?
It's fucking longer than 3 foot, mate.
So, again, okay, it just goes to show how much of an asset you are. Alright. So, let's move on. Let's move on from Slaughtering Grounds. Keep going. We've already... this is a blast.
Are you sure you don't want to carry on with the Slaughtering Grounds?
I mean, sure, let's talk about it more. You want to talk about...
The other artist's artwork that you used?
What other... Oh, the original one. That kind of falls into the whole Google thing. And that was removed several hours from the time that somebody pointed it out, and I realized that it was somebody else's. Similar to the thing that happened today with Medieval Mercs. Somebody pointed out that it was a Magic the Gathering image. I purchased the license from Shutterstock for that image. A commercial license to use it. Unlike you, who don't have to purchase anything, because it's fair use. Yeah, it's fair use. Yeah, you make money without investing any money. That's why it's such a humdug deal.
Anyways, you should see how expensive my microphone is.
Oh, yeah, one-time investment. A whole bunch of work.
Constantly upgrading it, so...
So, anyways, I purchased a license to use that. But I still took that image off of Medieval Mercs.
Because there's a whole trademark issue with using another game.
I have a license.
You have a license, but obviously another gameplay image, something within the realm of gaming, that's a conflict.
Shutterstock is selling commercial licenses for copyrighted objects. We're already going to contact them and get a refund and probably something else on top of that. If you want to point out some big criminal, point out Shutterstock. These people that are selling copyrighted images and stuff and saying that they have a commercial license, here you go, here's for a price. But they don't even have the rights to do that.
Well, that sounds pretty sucky. But I will say that for someone who tells me that I should be the one pouring an intense amount of research into First Impressions videos, you don't seem to be swallowing your own medicine.
What are you talking about?
Everything you talk about here speaks to your own lack of research, and I think when you're actively selling products to people on Steam, I would say there's a greater impetus for you to make sure that you're not treading on any toes copyright-wise.
So are we talking about Slaughtering Grounds, where I've already addressed it that I was new and didn't know any better at the time, and now I have learned my lessons, like today, where I have purchased the license, and the license person who issued the license is actually the one that is doing something criminal. That is my fault that I assumed buying a legal license to distribute something commercially. That's my fault?
Well, yeah, I mean, know who you're doing business with.
Shutterstock. Are they a shady company?
Know who you're doing business with. If they make a habit of this, as you've accused on discussion...
Of course you have an opinion on this, even though you don't have to do that. Because you just take images off the internet and use them without asking anybody, right?
I use images that are not covered by fair use, I seek permission. Assets that are not covered by fair use, I seek permission.
So you use lots of other people's work to create your own work?
For sure, yeah.
Okay, so that's exactly what I do with your asset flip. Let's talk about asset flipping.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so... You even have your own little art department or whatever that's made your cover thing?
Yes.
What is the difference between what you do there and what I do with the asset store?
The difference is that my entire... Like, an episode of The Jimquisition is not just the title credits and the end credits.
So you're saying that I put no work at all in my games?
I'm not saying you put no work in. I'm saying that, and this has obviously been backed up by the amount of customers that leave negative reviews, that you're not putting in the amount of effort that people expect from a professional's product on the Steam.
How would you have any idea about the effort that goes into making games? Do you make games?
I work with game developers very closely on certain projects.
Do you know how to code at all?
I personally do not know how to code at all.
Okay, because I don't know how to make videos. So I don't go out.
I thought your review, the review was quite good.
And that was just an early attempt. I mean, I could probably get pretty good if I tried, but I don't have time to do that. But if I was going to do that, I would at least put full amount of effort into it. Just like I put in effort with my games. You guys say that there's no effort at all put into this. There's been people that have come on the forums and say that we're way undercharging for the value of code that is involved. Somebody posted they get paid 60 cents a line for code. There is hundreds of thousands of lines of code that is involved in making these games. And that all of your followers come and spout and say, oh, it's so easy. If it's so easy, why don't they go do it? I'm not hiding where we get our stuff from. Go to the asset store, buy some assets, pick up a program. Unity is free. Go put something together. Don't stifle somebody because they're trying to do something new.
No one's stifling you. Criticism is not censorship. Let's get that out of the way. If anyone was doing stifling, again, it would come back to you.
Again, you refer to what you do as criticism. What you do is not criticism. What you do is attack people. If you had, let's go back to the slaughtering grounds.
I don't attack people, I attack products until the people behind those products make it personal.
You say that you don't attack people, you attack products. That's
until the people behind the products make it personal.
If you were talking about a AAA company that is actually a corporation, that is an accurate statement. If you were talking about an indie developer, you are directly attacking that person.
Yeah, but I don't talk about the developers when I do my initial videos. I talk about the product. I talk about, in the Slaughtering Grounds video, I talk about the Slaughtering Grounds. It was you who then turned it into a people issue.
You criticized my work, I criticized your work. I was saying that you did a poor job.
But then you started talking about what a moron I was.
Absolutely, I'm not going to take that back.
That's the point. You're the one who escalated it to criticizing people.
I escalated it? I wasn't the one that made the video first. You made the first video.
Yeah, but I made the video.
And you labeled it absolute shit. If you are saying that...
Yeah, but I didn't say you were absolute shit. This is the bit that you're struggling to grasp it.
No, I'm not struggling.
I didn't say you
criticized me for being a developer.
You fired back to call me absolute shit, and that's when we started attacking the people.
You criticized my work. Your work.
Because you criticized my work, and then you took it one step further and started leveling personal attacks and strawman attacks, which is why did the same. I responded
in kind. It is your job. You telling me that when you were playing that game, you couldn't see the ammo counter 2 inches below the crosshair? I mean, come on. We're going right back to what we were saying about you saying I'm an incompetent developer. As a game reviewer, you should be a very quality game player. By not seeing an ammo counter 2 inches below the center, it's absolutely terrible.
I'm fairly certain I made intense fun of your ammo counters.
No. We can go back and watch the video right now if you would like to do it. I'm not...
Because the ammo... only corresponds to the gun you have.
I don't say something that I haven't investigated. Unlike you, where you just continually spout off stuff without actually looking into anything. It doesn't matter if it's true. Just like the lies on the forums about, you know, you've banned people unfairly and blah, blah, blah. These people, there's tons of people who have offered criticism, and they've pointed out tons of bugs. And you can go on my Deadly Prophets forum, and you can see they've pointed out bugs. I comment in the thread, hey, thanks, man. I fixed this. That's what you don't do. As a critique, you need to be saying, this is the positive, this is the negative. You need to fix this. You're not offering a fair critique.
I never reviewed the Slaughtering Grounds.
You have said what you do is criticism. We can rewind
this. Criticism. I criticize the thing that I'm playing in a first impressions environment, but I have never actually reviewed. I don't know if you've ever been to thejunkposition.com. I highly recommend it. It's a fantastic website. But there you'll see what an actual review that I produce looks like.
Okay, so if what you didn't do isn't a critique, then what is it?
Right. Again, this is... You seem to struggle with definitions.
No, it's not that I struggle.
I criticize things within a first environment blind play. Blind playing is a very popular, rather ubiquitous form of let's playing.
Okay, so...
I'm not
that's
doing anything
a good
particularly
point.
New there.
That's a good point. So, if you take my gameplay out of your video, what's going to happen to your... If all of the gameplay's taken out of videos, because written reviews are going down the crapper. We know written reviews are losing drastically to gameplay videos. And why is that? It's because you are showing tons of gameplay as you go through. If you take the gameplay out of your video, what's going to happen to your subscribership? Do you think it will go down? Do you think your views will go down if there is no gameplay shown?
I'm struggling to see the point, because we, like if Unity stopped selling assets, would you even have any games?
Oh,
like,
yeah.
We can all play this. We can all do this whole, something else wasn't there, could you do your thing?
Could you draw a banana dude that you use in your stuff? You could probably do it. I bet you could do it. I bet you could draw a banana guy to use in your video, but why do you do it? Why do you use somebody else's? Because it saves you time. It saves you time.
The banana guy's funny. People like banana guys.
Doug, answer my question specifically. Don't try and branch off from the subject.
I answered the question.
It saves you time. Is that correct?
Banana guy's funny. Have you seen banana guy?
Does it save you time using the banana image?
Not really, no. Because I have a whole bunch of stock images that I drew myself that I used to use in the early videos, but...
Well, then why did you switch?
Because I didn't like them. I found Banana Guy and
so the
funny.
So the other one's better. So you use that
it's
one
funny.
Instead of doing it yourself. So then what is the issue with me paying, at least I pay them, to use their product?
Right,
what
again,
what
the difference is that when people pay, you know, say $10 for the slaughtering grants, and then are dropped into this huge map where... USPS post boxes are right next to London phone boxes, and none of the enemies seem to exist in a coherent universe. It just looks like a mess. Now, I have never said that reusing assets is a bad thing. Even Unit Z, which I criticize a lot, using it as a base and turning it into a coherent product with your own original material, that's not a bad thing. The difference is the stopping point. It's like, where do you stop? And with Slaughtering Grounds, you clearly stopped after a certain level. Now, I'm not saying you didn't do coding. What I'm saying is you stopped to the level where the game had any sense of artistic cohesion, any sense of the disparate elements of the game belonging in the same world, which led to a very bad, alienating product.
So, let's go back a little bit, because you rambled on a bit. It's not $10, it's 99 cents. Slaughtering Grounds is 99 cents. Okay.
Right. It was $10 then.
It was $10 then. We were also new then. Okay? And just like that, we have been upfront and fair about everything. We have lowered the prices on our game because we realize that the value of those games is lower than we expected them to be valued higher, which you see a lot of developers doing. They're releasing their games at $9.99 for a low-quality product. But nobody tells anybody what the value of their product should be.
Okay.
The 99 cents is a completely fair price. It goes on sale for 20 cents sometimes. They are getting trading cards that are actually end up being worth more than the game, so they end up getting the game for free. Wait. All of our stuff, I have not said it's a AAA game. I have actually gone the opposite direction. I realize there's issues with them. So I have lowered the prices of those games so that it's more fair and people are happier, more happy with their purchase. They don't feel like, oh, I just paid $10 for a turd. It's totally, there's 99 cents, wait for it to go on sale, you'll pick it up basically for free. Is that not fair to do for the consumer?
You lowering the price, and I said this with the temper tantrum thing, it's a fairly commendable thing. I still don't think it's worth 99 cents, but it's still commendable that you dropped it to that for a much more reasonable price.
Is it worth 19 cents? Because it was just on sale for 19 cents.
Mm. I mean...
At 19
cents... For your very first game, I mean, time was, people didn't really sell them until they popped them on Newgrounds.
So if I go to the arcade and I put a quarter in the machine, and I get 10 minutes of play out of the arcade machine. You remember arcade machines, right? They're not around a whole lot anymore, but even 20 years ago, it was still a quarter in an arcade machine, right?
Well, it was 50p. It would have been 50p for me back in the day. Smash TV, Final Fight, in a pub in Yarmouth.
Exactly. Great times. So for that 10 minutes, it cost you a quarter. So what you're saying, by saying Temper Tantrum is not worth 19 cents, you're saying you can't get your videos longer than 10 minutes, isn't it? Doesn't that mean that you've gotten your value for the money?
No, because simple time is not value. I mean, there are certain, like Final Fantasy XIII can be played for 80 hours or so, and it's a train wreck. Whereas something like Portal is, you know, 4 hours or so, give or take, and is a far better quality product.
So there's no...
The quality of time is a lot more important than simply time.
There's no room for anything except AAA, right? So if that's the logic behind what you're saying is, then there's no room for these lower-end YouTuber guys. We got PewDiePie and all them. They do AAA quality YouTube reviews. Why do we need you then?
I'm really not sure what you're talking about there. I mean...
We'll rewind it back so you can understand it.
You're going to have to... I apologize for the stuttering. I'm really just trying to...
You're saying there is no room... There's no room for the games that I make because they're too low a quality. Because there's AAA studios putting out AAA quality games.
No, there's no room. I mean, there's room. There's plenty of room. Steam's opened the floodgates. There's room. What I'm saying is it's very hard to justify a game of your low quality. Not because of AAA quality, but because games like Her Story exist, This War of Mine exists,
All the upcoming YouTubers should quit, because there's already AAA YouTubers making YouTube videos. All the guys just starting out, they should quit right now so that, you know, that we already have AAA.
Like, let's look at someone like Lee Alexander, who's only just started doing videos. She does lo-fi let's plays, and they're fantastic.
By saying if they're good, you're inferring that since I'm not good at making games, what you say, I should quit. But we've already determined...
I never said you should quit.
...that my games are getting better. And they are a little more complicated than making a video. Because just like you said, my video that I did for Slaughtering Grounds wasn't that bad. And I haven't even done crap for videos. I've done barely any. Yet you criticize something that takes a massive amount of effort, work, and you gotta be smart to do it. It is very frustrating coding stuff. If you did some, you would understand it. Whereas you make a video, it doesn't take a high level of skill to make a video. Personalities.
I'll pass that along to, you know, to the likes of Andy Joe and Total Biz.
That's fine. Tell them.
Know that the computer takes no skill for them to do what they do. I think they're very talented.
No. Do not twist what I said around. I said it does not take a high amount of skill to make a video. It's their personalities is what sells their product. That is why your audience is so aggressive. Because you spur on that type of audience. You project your crap and bullshit ideas onto other people, and they love it because that's how they feel in life at the time. They have this hate, they're bitter, and then you come along and say, hey, we can go crap on this guy, and that's what they go do for you. You've even said it in some of your videos, that's what I need a group of people to go and attack, and we'll make...
I have never said that.
Oh, yes.
Actually,
we can link it right now if you want. It's in one of your videos. It's actually pretty recent. Look,
it's 2 years.
Oh, it's 2 years?
Dummy.
Just a sec. I'll look it up for you. Because, you know, you're saying that you've never said that, but you have. Let's see if,
Escapist 2012.
It's from Escapist 2012. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to hear it.
Just caught me here, and just about Kate's caught me in the middle of it.
Can you hear? Can you hear what I'm putting on?
Yep.
Atlas Perfection. Oh, hello there. You just caught me in the middle of a little bit of an experiment. I'm trying to create a race of subhuman creatures who are subservient and just about capable of taking simple orders and demolishing certain public places.
That pretty much sums up exactly what you do. It is so accurate about what you do.
That's your smoking gun.
No.
Your smoking gun. It's a joke about me creating a race of creatures.
There has been 10 smoking guns.
Me parodying science fiction tropes is your evidence I tell people I need them to go and attack people like you.
That's what you do. That is what you do, and you get off on the attacking of people. Whatever happened to that, what was it, Poxel Z guy? I found it so humorous that you banned him and deleted his comment and was upset that he was harassing you. What is it you describe you've been doing for the past 9 months to me?
I do not do anything to you. I cover your games, and I actually condemn harassment.
You condemn harassment, but
absolutely. I'm not a big fan of harassment.
There are thousands of games that have been released on Steam, but you have managed to do a video on every single one of my games. You don't think that qualifies as harassment?
I don't know. I'd be interested in...
It's good to live in denial.
Let's not forget that there was kind of a dip in me covering your stuff. I hadn't mentioned you for a while. And then you brought up the whole Steam trading card thing and did that funny little Unity asset with the Russian roulette pose. And that seemed to suggest that you wanted this to continue.
That I wanted this to continue?
Apparently so. I mean, the fact you're here right now seems to suggest that you...
Oh, the fact that I'm here right now?
The very thing that you claim you don't want to happen.
I'm glad you... For you, this is... You probably think this is for publicity, but this isn't for publicity. This is specifically to make points. It's going to be... I'm happy we're doing this. There's tons of stuff. I haven't even heard anything from you that I haven't had an answer yet. Do you have anything to say that isn't just complete opinion? Do you have any factual stuff?
My business is opinion.
What?
My business is opinion. Are we at the point now where we're criticizing pundits for having opinions?
Your business is criticism, right? Which is an opinion, as long as it's a fair critique.
This comes back to your confusion as to what fair use is.
No. I said have
but
a fair critique.
You said that fair use has to be fair. That's why it's called fair use.
A quality reviewer will say positive and negative. If you want me to fix something, post it on my forums and I'll fix it. You can go through all my forums and see. Look at Deadly Prophets. I started from the very beginning. There is development notes all the way back to the beginning. I list everything that was worked on. I responded to people and I fixed everything that they posted that was wrong. I'm not sure what it is you're upset about that I'm making it so that criticism is not available. It's not that
I'm not the one upset here. You're the one who seems so desperate to have this conversation.
Because
I'm perfectly fine continuing to look at your games and saying what I think about
them. Of course you're fine. You have no financial investment in what you do. Yet you affect tons of developers' lives. Financially affect them. That is why one day you're going to have enough subscribers. You're going to make enough money on your Patreon thing, and somebody's going to get tired of your shit, and they're going to sue you. So I'm not saying we are. I'm saying somebody's going to have the money to do it, and they're going to win.
Oh, is that what we've devolved into?
Exactly. You keep laughing.
You're saying it's amusing.
No, nothing in this is amusing. The reason it's amusing to you is because it doesn't affect you financially. You get off on this crap. This isn't funny. You are affecting people's lives. You are lying about
shit. You just said
that
I'm going to get sued and lose for doing my job, same job that hundreds of people do.
No. I'm not saying you're going to get sued and lose because you're making a critique, or even a negative critique. I'm saying you're going to other people's content. That is why I'm saying you're going to be sued and lose. Maliciously. Nice. Maliciously doing it. And it's no, it doesn't matter. It's irrelevant. This is something that's going to be brought up years from now. It doesn't, hopefully the courts and everything will get the gray taken out of copyright stuff. Because the gray area is where the problem is. But it'll be taken care of. Is there anything else? So we've gotten it narrowed down. You've pointed out the Google image. I haven't denied that. I was new. It's been replaced. It's been removed from the game and a new image has been put in. What else? You complained about asset flipping, but it's been shown that that's exactly what you do, except I actually pay for my licenses. What else do we got going on?
I guess I'm really confused as to why you think that you have to talk positively about a game even if you don't see any positives in the game.
There's zero positives. Nothing.
About which game are we talking?
Any of them.
Well, those games where I did have positive things to say, I said it.
So, Temper Tantrum and Slaughtering Grounds, you say, has absolutely no positive things in it at all. Do you think the gun sounds in the Slaughtering Grounds are bad?
Yes.
Okay, because those are done by Boom Library. Do you know who Boom Library is?
They're still bad.
You think the gun sounds... Boom Library does cinematic sounds for games like Attila. And all kind of, they do professional sound work. Go look them up. You don't investigate your stuff, so I know that this is new news to you. But Boom Library is actually a very big in media. Go look at their stuff.
Okay. I don't see how.
But their gun sounds.
Being in media.
Their gun sounds are actually.
I mean, hell, Warner Brothers is a massive multi-million-dollar corporation, and their game, when that came out on PC, their last one, Arkham Knight, was a load of shit. So
they fire.
Size of business.
They fire
does
guns.
Not equate quality of product.
They have videos of them doing it. They have massive amounts of sound equipment, and they fire guns and record the sound.
Right.
So what you're saying is that real bullet sounds and shot sounds sound bad.
They didn't sound good in your game.
They're direct clips. There's no modification. You know we don't do any modification to our stuff, right? There's no modification. So what you're saying is that a real gunshot sounds bad.
Okay, but let me follow up on that question by saying this. You are suggesting that the positive in the Slaughtering Grounds is somebody else's work, and I should be praising that company.
At least praise somebody. You said there, the whole point was, you said there was nothing positive about the Slaughtering Grounds.
I did not find anything positive in the Slaughtering Grounds. No.
But that is why we're talking about gun sounds. Those are professionally done. Gun sounds good? They are real gun sounds. Super high quality. Those gun sounds.
It didn't work with the game that you produced, my friend.
That is not, those gun sounds specifically, are those a good sound effect?
Not in the game that you produced.
So,
as I said before, everything's an artistic mishmash in there.
So
the elements of the game are so disparate that it doesn't matter even if you had something good that you bought from someone else and put in the game. As a cohesive whole, there is nothing appealing about the Slaughtering Grounds.
As a cohesive whole? That isn't what I've asked, though. I've asked if there is any positive elements in the game, and you have said no.
Yeah, I have said no, and I stick by that.
Of course you do. I've just shown you that that isn't the...
No, you haven't. You've said, in your opinion, that the gunshots are good.
The gunshots are done professionally.
Doesn't matter. Arkham Knight was done professionally, and that was an absolute mess on PC.
I take the time to go look up what other games those gun sounds... have been used in, and I bet they've been used
in... And they probably fit in a lot better, because they probably...
It doesn't matter how they fit in.
Them.
It doesn't matter
it
how
does
they...
It does matter.
No!
You're the artist.
I asked,
surely you want
I
to
asked
the
you...
A,
I,
unity.
I asked you to point out, is there anything positive in the game? I didn't ask you, is the whole game positive? I said, is this positive, or is this positive, or is this positive?
Right, but you
said the gunshot sounds are not positive. You said the gunshot sounds are not positive. So I'll go up later, and I'll look to see what AAA studio, because they are used by AAA games, has used that, and I bet you've done a good review for them, and you've probably even mentioned that, wow, those gunshot sounds were good.
I can guarantee you right now, in a review, I have never written, wow, those gunshot sounds are good.
Okay. Yeah, of course.
I guarantee it.
It's probably just like you've never actually called for a group of people to go attack somebody when I just played that for you.
You seem to think that's real.
I see. Because
you seem to think, do you think I'm actually breeding creatures in a laboratory somewhere demolish public property?
You must not frequent my forums.
Right, but do you think that I actually created those in a lab, like, say, breeding them with a howler monkey? This isn't specific denial. I'm definitely not breeding people with howler monkeys.
No, it's not a mad scientist kind of thing. I know you want to...
But that's what I was doing in that video.
You want to do some flair to it and make it seem like something blah, blah, blah. That isn't what I'm saying. What I'm saying is that you tell a lot of false information, and those people then spew that false information, and it spreads like wildfire. Just like Angry Joe. Angry Joe had a problem with Pro Phil or whatever the heck his name is. Bro Pill Team, right? So he had a problem with that guy because Bro Pill Team had him remove an image. He put an image on Angry Joe's video, and he took that. He DMCA'd that image because he said something like this can ruin somebody in hours. Because he did not want to be associated with that.
Mm.
What you do can ruin people in hours. You seem to think it's amusing, and that's why this is so malicious. What you do, and when you think it's no big deal, you prove it every time you open your mouth that what
you would have to prove malice, because there is not malice until, again, maliciousness has been thrown my way.
You
are the guys that escalated this. I covered the game like I cover every game. I went in blind, I gave my impressions,
Thank you for saying that. It's not that we're special. You attack everybody that you come in contact with. Except games that you deem are worthy, but the only reason you deem that they're worthy is they've already got positive reviews on their thing, and you go with the bandwagon.
Right, except I was the very first person to review her story, and I was very positive about it, and now everyone else is calling it Game of the Year material. So that's
her story. Her story, what are you talking about?
It's a game. It's a video game.
Oh, okay, I know what video game you're talking about. Actually, that brings me to something. Do you know what Courtney Stanton?
I know of Courtney Stanton. I've heard the name, yeah.
You're not related to her at all?
No.
Okay, because you've supported her all over the web. I've seen some posts of yours where... So you guys do know each other?
No.
Okay, so now you don't know her?
I know of her. I know the name.
You've posted on her posts. So you know her.
You're going to have to remind me.
Courtney Stanton. The same last name that you have.
Yeah.
You're not related, though.
No.
Okay, but you do know her.
Hang on. I'm going to have to, I've seen the name. I'm not that familiar with her work. I may have reacted to something she's written in the past, but don't really know her.
Alright, we'll let it go.
Are you trying to imply we're related?
It would be very interesting if you guys were related, but we'll just let...
But we're not. It's actually a common name in Britain.
In Britain?
It's... Yeah.
Yeah, well, I don't have... I don't like to say something that
it's
I don't...
It's all drainage covers, actually.
I don't like to say something that I don't have factual proof of what I'm saying before I say it. So, since I can't verify anything else, we can move on from there.
Right, that didn't quite go the way you were hoping for it to go, did it?
Well, you know, I don't want to say something I don't have proof of. You do that frequently.
Well, I mean, you tried.
At least I asked. You don't ask before you spout your nonsense. You don't care if it's true.
What am I supposed to ask about the slaughtering grounds? What could I ask you about the slaughtering grounds that would make me enjoy it?
You could offer, email me a message and say, hey, you should do this and this and this. I actually thought about emailing you a key for Medieval Mercs before I released it, so that you could give some whatever your insights are, and right. You should make the game better. But honestly, it's...
I mean, I find that interesting as someone who was just trying to intimate a conflict of interest. Do you not feel that would be a conflict of interest if I suddenly started working some sort of QA on you before I actually covered the games?
Hey, say again, I guess I'm not following what you're saying.
Right, I'm saying as someone who just tried to intimate some sort of unfair collusion between me and this poor dissident person, do you not think it would be a similar conflict of interest if I was privately contacting you with advice, basically what they call consultancy, without sort of, and then going on to review the product, or criticize the product, or do whatever coverage I deem fit with the product?
You asked for a key for Forsaken Uprising.
No, I never.
Oh, yeah, you did.
No, I never.
Well, we have an email. That wasn't you that got a key for it?
No.
Okay, then I guess we, as usual, people ask for free keys. That somebody's impersonating you, then.
It happens a lot.
It does.
Again, as someone who's asking for me to verify everything before they say things, you seem to be hurling a lot of accusations first and then getting shut down. So I'd probably relax.
Actually, at least we're having a one-on-one conversation where you can verify that what I said wasn't true. Whereas you just post stuff, and it doesn't matter if it's true or not, and I have no say.
Right, but what?
So at least we're back and forth, and you can verify that.
What actual lies do you think I'm saying about you?
What lies? I just told you a list of lies. Let's start with the forum.
Any differences of opinion?
No. You said that I banned people from the Slaughtering Grounds contest.
That's been reported from people.
That I was... yeah, it's been reported. Did you follow up? Nope.
I checked out the posts. I've seen a lot of people who have said fairly innocuous shit. I've seen people who have sent you actual detailed criticism of your games, and you've responded to them with YouTube videos and thrown them into some little mini-forum, like sub-forum. I've seen people giving me rather detailed advice on how to behave, how to conduct yourself if you want to have any shred of positive PR, and you've shut them down. So what's the next?
You can go look at Deadly Prophet's forums right now. Go look at it. Go look through. You will see posts, there's like 23 posts in the bug report section, mm-hmm. and you'll see that I address each one of those issues.
I believe you that when it comes to basic bug reporting, you have, you know, you're responding to them.
Yeah, the people that get...
I'm not saying I've seen you never respond positively to criticism.
The people that get banned are the people who come across like you do. At least have a little respect when you come across as an asshole. If you had approached the Slaughtering Grounds as, hey, you know, this is the Slaughtering Grounds... da 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 da. It's got tons of bugs and stuff. You know, try it out, and if you don't like it, you know, post, and we'll start asking them if they're gonna fix this stuff. You don't approach it from. You just automatically attack. You label it as absolute shit, right? That's what you do. How can you expect a positive response from a negative attack?
Right.
Why should I owe you the courtesy? Why do I owe you the courtesy of a positive response when you attack me and talk shit? How is that fair?
You owe yourself to maybe let it go.
No. I don't have to let shit go. I'm not electronic.
I'm not saying you have to do that.
I'm not Electronic Arts, all right? This isn't going to affect $1 million bottom line. I can tell you my opinion, and I don't blow smoke up anybody's ass about anything.
Right. That's fine. You've got a right to do that. I've got a right to say your game's absolute shit. You've got a right to call me a moron and say you're fucking Sterling son. And
absolutely.
Then I've got a right to respond to that. I mean, I don't see what your problem is with
but, any of that. But the problem is that you say that you do criticism, that you are trying to help the community by getting these bad games out of the system and stop them from coming through green light. If you wanted
to... I don't actually say that. All I do is shine a light on the shit that I find.
You shine a light on the shit that you find.
Oh, yes.
So, I can't really argue that Greenlight's got some pretty amazing stuff on it. But the games that make it through Greenlight, there's some that are low-end games, but there's more content and more content being developed. And it's like, if no new YouTubers are allowed to make any more content, how can any more new great YouTubers come to exist? Eventually, you're going to be 60.
Right,
you're going to be 60 years old, and nobody's going to want to watch your videos about a 60-year-old guy doing videos. So there has to be some room for new people trying to do something different. A lot of the people that come on the forums to spout their crap, it's not that they hate what we're doing. It's that they don't have the balls to go do it themselves. All of the tools are available for you to do it. Go do it. Do it better than what I'm doing. I'm not trying to stifle anybody from doing something new. If they want to send me an email, I'll give them suggestions on things that I've learned as I've gone through stuff. You don't want to offer any kind of help to anybody like that?
Well, actually, I've been fairly helpful to any up-and-coming YouTubers who want advice.
Oh, YouTubers.
Well, yeah, if we're talking... Because you keep likening what you do to what I do, so I'm talking about what I do. If you keep shining this... like turning this around into what I do for a living. So I'm letting you know what I do for a living.
Yeah, what you do for a living's great.
It's pretty good.
Yeah, I know. You've even commented about, your videos, somebody CPV'd it, and, haha, too late, I already spent the money on sweets. Yeah, that's really classy. They took that video, and your response was, haha, I already spent the money. That is corporate style mentality of, haha, you're not going to get a cent, even though it's owed to you. Nice.
Well, actually, when it comes to the music industry's flagrant overuse of the automated YouTube system, I absolutely have no sympathy for them at all. But I've talked about this in multiple
ways. Why is it your right to use somebody else's song in your stuff? Why do I have to pay for a license?
I don't know, ask Capcom. You'll have to ask Capcom and even Electronic Arts, who have actually reversed a lot of those music-based content ID claims.
It's because...
They seem to think it's fine.
It's more...
You'll have to ask Devolver Digital, who seem to think
it's more bad publicity for them than it's worth monetarily. That is why they do that stuff.
So you're saying that it's actually worth more monetarily to you to take videos down?
What videos have we taken down? The one that only video that we've DMCA'd, we've let it go and put it back up. Is that not right? We haven't taken anything else down. And I haven't made any new videos.
Why take it down if it's not... You seem to say that for EA, it's financially in their best interest to reverse Content ID.
Why do they want to... Why would EA want to start a war? Why would
out these logic bombs that I'm just trying to understand, because it's like an explosion of arguments and the shrapnel's going everywhere. I'm just trying to piece everything together.
Seem like what I'm saying isn't logical. We can go rewind back and ask me what it is that you don't think is logical. Hey, feel free.
Pretty much all of it. I mean, the correlation between YouTube and game development. I don't understand what you're doing there. I don't understand how you seem to think that no one has a right to fair use of assets, and yet when companies like Devolver Digital...
Fair use of assets? You're the one that said I shouldn't be using other people's assets.
I never said you shouldn't be using them.
You've labeled it as asset flip. That's the thing that's going around. It's plaguing all the forums that it's a filthy and horrible thing to do.
Right, because when you just do what is basically Little Big Planet...
That is your opinion, and it is an uneducated opinion. you are saying that my game is just completely assets made by somebody else, which is completely fictitious. My game would not even function without my code. Not even work. It would be like pressing play on your video and only your picture being there. That is what it would be like. Is there something wrong with that logic?
Right. As I've explained before, though...
Is there something wrong with that logic? Answer my question!
Yes, there's something wrong with that logic.
Okay, point out why there's something wrong with it.
The difference between what you do and what another game that uses assets does is that there's nothing else there. Yes,
there's no code involved. No code.
There's nothing else there for the end user.
There's no code...
There's nothing else. What you just said is that games are complete art and there is no code available. There's a bunch of new gameplay elements, new weaponry. It builds upon the foundation of the assets.
So your videos with tons of pictures and all that stuff, that would be plenty. You don't have to put your words or anything with it. That is what you're saying. You're saying that a game is complete art. There is nothing else involved in it. And that is why what you say is ignorant.
No, I'm saying that the art has to work together with all of the other elements, which is what asset flip games don't do.
No. You've said that I don't put anything into it. I put nothing in there. All I do
Earlier
is I
in
take
this conversation, I admitted that you do the programming needed to make all the parts move.
Okay,
I'm not saying you don't.
So, well, you haven't made that clear in the past. Because all of your followers think that all I do is do what Postal Z does, which is buy a completed game off of Unity and then post it. That is what you make people believe, and that is a lie.
Actually, I do not do that. In Jim Positions discussing these things, I've discussed the difference between Unity asset flipping and the kind of asset flipping that leads to, again, this is what I've said before, the lack of artistic
Maybe we should go listen to that Jim Position, because I'm in that Jim Position, and you label what I do as wrong, just like what they do.
It's wrong, and it's similar, but
why is it wrong?
Yes.
Why is it wrong?
Why is it wrong? For the reasons I've just given you over the past hour.
Give me the reason it's wrong in one sentence, right here.
Taking disparate Unity assets that have no relation to each other and mashing them together in a game is an audiovisual mess.
Okay, that's your opinion, right? Do you not do the same thing with your videos? You take assets, put them together, and then put your video up. Your contribution to that, because you say that you are a derivative work, Your contribution is your critique, is what you're saying in your Jim Position, right? My contribution to my work is my coding. What we do is very, almost exactly the same. Why is it not? Do you use assets for your stuff?
Artistic audiovisual consistency in what I do.
No.
It makes sense.
But you're arguing an opinion part of it. I am arguing fact part. I am not saying what I do is great.
We can all do that. I'm not saying what I do is amazing.
I'm not saying what you do is bad.
Focus on these basic little factoids to try and say that these two things are totally identical. But the real life doesn't work that way. You can't
just strip away your stuff. Your stuff uses assets. You use other people's work to make your product. I use other people's art to make my product. I contribute to my product. You contribute to your product. You're saying what I do is wrong, making you a hypocrite. There is nothing.
The reasons I've already given.
I cannot. How can you argue with that logic? What you do is wrong because
the games just aren't enjoyable to play because it's full of errors and bullshit that doesn't get fixed.
You're then again making an opinion. I'm going to keep saying it,
and I know you think I sound like a stuck record, but you're just not letting the argument sink in. There is no goddamn audiovisual unity to the things you do. It's just shit thrown together.
Okay.
That's what it looks like to the end
okay,
user.
Perfect. You are, let's say, for your sake, for just for hypothetical sake, let's say what you just said is absolutely true. Let's just say, hypothetically, what you said is completely accurate. Now, back to the fact of it, do I use assets?
Yes.
Do you use assets?
Yes.
Okay. Do you make something with somebody else's stuff and add your portion of contribution to that piece of art?
I mean, I'll go with you on this, sure, yeah.
Okay, and what I do, I use somebody else's art, and I add my code to it, and I make a product. You may not like my product, that is totally fine, but you are saying the way in which I do it is not okay, when in fact, it is the exact same way that you do something.
My problem is the results of what you do.
No, but in the past, that is not what you said your problem was. In the past...
You can re-listen to the video. When I talk about the method, when I talk about purely the method, Unit Z is the one I focus on the most. That's the most, audacious abuse of assets.
Unity is the one that you focus on the most? I'm pretty sure I have the most coverage.
I talk about the lack of artistic cohesion.
I definitely have the most coverage out of anybody else that you do videos on. Maybe there's a AAA studio that you've done more videos on? Probably. But...
There's been a couple, yeah.
But as far as...
You don't get anywhere near as mentioned as Ubisoft or Konami.
But as far as an indie developer, I'm the butt of your jokes all the time.
Well,
and, you know, you're entitled to your opinion. What you're not entitled to do is lie. Saying that what we are doing by flipping assets is a lie. That is a lie. You are doing the exact same thing. You take a product, somebody else's stuff, you put it in your video, and then you put it up there so it'll make you money. I use somebody else's art, I put my code into it, I develop a game, whether you think it's good or not, because I think a lot of your videos are shit, but it's still a video. It's still a video. And I'm not saying you're not good at what you do. I've actually told people the other. I think it is amazing the influence that you have on people. You have a pretty profound effect on a very closed-minded amount of people who are looking to attack games and find you their go-to man for where they can focus their attention on. But you can't argue with what I've... You can, you will. But right. you won't have any valid logical points. You can't.
You're getting very circular with this. Like, you just keep coming back to things that I've refuted already.
You say that you refuted. It boggles my mind that there's nothing similar about your video's construction and the games that I construct. There's no correlation there at all, is what you're saying.
Not when we look at the actual mediums themselves, no. I will go with you as far as when you explain it in the absolutely minimalist, remedial, fundamental way that you've deliberately designed your argument, then yes, there's a similarity between the two things.
You find it...
What I'm saying is when there's an actual context involved, which, to me, maybe that's just me as a critic speaking versus you as a programmer.
Exactly. Because, again, you're putting an opinion. You're putting an opinion. Like what you say, criticism is an opinion. You're taking factual portion and mixing it with opinion. I don't want to talk about opinion. You have your videos to talk about opinion. What I want to talk about is facts. That's it. I don't want to hear your opinion.
You probably want to speak to a scientist or something if you just want to talk about facts. Talking to a critic is probably not the best thing to do, especially when you're talking about his media.
No, hold on, I'm watching a mad scientist.
Simple household talk.
Yeah, I just...
That was a funny bit. I'm glad you like it.
It's entertaining. You got some entertaining stuff. I'm not saying you don't.
Thank you.
Yeah, you do. But what you do... When you attack people, there's so many targets
again,
out there that need...
You started with the attacking of the people.
You do. There's so many legitimate... Like the Shutterstock thing. You should blow up on this Shutterstock thing. They are making millions of dollars by selling copyrighted material. You should go ask them if they know what's going on. It seems weird because they have 4,000 plus images submitted by a guy. Hey, why don't you investigate things that really need to be investigated? Do people really need your video saying, hey, this game's a piece of shit? Do they really need that video? No, they want to see it. But you have used other people's stuff, including mine, and made money off of it. I've used other people's stuff and made money off of it, but at least I've paid them to use it. You haven't paid anything. You bought your microphone, as you said earlier. I take
that. And I've also paid for all of the original artwork that goes into the show. All of the stuff that's actual Gym Position branded stuff.
Oh, that. Is all the image on the front?
The backing music. The artwork. I'm working with artists right now on a whole range of
things. I'm not really that familiar with the song. Is that an original song?
Oh, you're talking about the theme song?
Yeah.
That was an agreement between me and a band called Drill Queen.
Yeah, I really wasn't
familiar. And very
much
like you not wanting to talk about Steam sales, I'm not going to go too much into that.
It's a good song.
The backing music that is used, which is called Gymstick 2. The backing music was composed for me by Dary Baranovsky. That was a professional contribution. That's, again, something, a business arrangement between us two. I have stuff that I pay.
You don't have any other songs in any of your videos?
Outside of those two?
Yeah.
No.
There's no...
The earlier ones did, and then I stopped that. Again, for the same reason as you gave earlier.
Oh, so when you were new, you accidentally did that, but now that you know better, you don't do that anymore. That sounds really familiar.
Right.
Right.
Right, so I really appreciative of this whole we're not so different you and I thing that you're doing. It's actually one of my favorite TV Tropes pages. But again, there's a big difference between you actively selling a product on Steam where people expect a certain level of quality and me doing what were originally amateur videos.
They're expecting a certain level of quality.
Amateur videos money.
Have I misled them in some way? Have I posted on there that has anything in my description? There's a video showing gameplay. There's links to other videos showing gameplay. There's screenshots. There's a description of the game. Is any of my descriptions false? Do I say there's 100 levels or something, and then probably, there's only 20?
I'm just saying, you're probably better served. And again, I'm not going to argue your rights. You've got every right to do it on Steam. I'm just saying you're probably better served putting it on somewhere like Newgrounds first until you've kind of got your chops together.
Well, everybody's entitled to their opinion.
Absolutely. And I'm glad that you've given me yours.
Opinion, though. Don't present what you have as fact when it's in fact not factual. Like, you're banning a bunch of people from your contest. That's not true at all. That's not what happened. But you said that it was fact.
Well,
and other people believe that what you said was fact.
Well, people have reported that to me. I checked it out.
Why didn't you send me an email and ask me?
Because at the time,
because you don't care about the truth.
Because at the time, you guys had no social media presence that I could see.
Our support email. It's right on every single game that we have. You have every means to contact me.
I did not see that support email. The first time we ever got contact was when you hit me with the reviewer video. Which again, if we're talking about you should have reached out first, maybe you could have reached out to me before making several accusations in that video.
I totally agree with you. I even said in the slaughtering rant thing that maybe my video at the time was a bit of an overreaction. Although, not undeserved. You attacked, I attacked you back. But I took mine off, whereas you have continually posted it over and over and over and over and over because it is beneficial to you. Right?
I posted it over and over and over again because it makes a damn fine point.
Is there a punchline?
No.
A damn fine point about what?
a damn fine point about everything I've said about Steam's quality control. As well as, so, you know, how not to do PR for a game, how to preserve one's reputation, how to not handle criticism.
But I've already shown you, it's not that we can't handle criticism. It's the lack of respect when the criticism is offered. All you have to do is say, hey man, this crap, dude, you broke this, this is messed up, this doesn't work, hey, are you guys going to fix it? You don't say that. You automatically label it a pile of shit without allowing anybody even a chance to fix something.
Yeah, because I'm not your QA tester.
You're not my QA tester.
No, I'm not.
But, so you just feed off of that type of thing. That's just what you make a living. Sorry, I'm looking at a video image of you looking creepy with a needle, so...
I love that bit. Let's redo that.
Okay. Do you got anything else? I think this has been great.
I had a good laugh.
I know you always think it's funny because it has no. It only makes even this video, even though I've logically pointed out all types of crap. This will still only benefit you. You'll get tons of views out of it, and that's why these court cases aren't happening either. And that's why Electronic Arts and them don't.
And why aren't the court cases happening?
I said not happening.
Yeah, why aren't they happening? Sorry, I got
it. Because it just benefits you guys. You guys.
See, that's why you're not doing the court case, because it benefits me. Not because you don't have time for it or because you don't have the money for it. Sorry, it's just this is the third reason you've given.
Yeah, okay. Whatever it is you try.
Whichever reason you want to give at the time, let me know, because it's hard to follow the storyline.
Okay, there's three different reasons.
Three different reasons.
Okay, yeah.
Okay.
What is it you think that you're making some fantastic point
about? Well, I'm making a quadrology.
Okay, well, elaborate.
I don't know how I can elaborate from the simple question. I was just trying to find out what reason the lawsuit didn't happen. Because you gave one reason, then another, now this new one. And then I said you want to make it a quadrology.
You're saying...
the alien resurrection of it at all. And I don't
I said lawsuits.
Was the film that
I said lawsuits.
Was treated fairly.
Right? We can run it back. I'm pretty sure I said lawsuits. Not meaning just me individually. Lawsuits in general. You can twist my words around, but luckily we have it recorded so we can go back. I said lawsuits. Meaning there's other people. Also, though, this is their reason for probably not doing it. Serious, there's a bunch of reasons why you're getting away with what you get away with. The big companies, it's not worth their time because it'll hurt them more by making it a scene when you don't have enough viewers to affect them. Whereas a little company, these games that only have 10 or 15 reviews, when you do a bad review and spew your crap about them, your followers then go and buy the game specifically to leave a bad review. You cause bad conversions. Do you know what a bad conversion is?
Enlightenment.
Okay, so a bad conversion is somebody, attention is given to a game, to an audience that normally wouldn't even like that game. But since you gave it coverage, they go and buy it. They don't like that type of game. They're already negatively disposed to leave a bad review on that game. I would rather none of your viewers bought my game. Is that
right?
I can't promise you guys to buy your games. Absolutely. I do not want your audience. Don't buy my game. Don't come to my forum. I will live without you guys. It will be okay for me. Matter of fact, it will be even better. Please have your audience stay away from my games.
I will beg them not to buy your games.
Beg them not to stop by the forums. Okay? Please don't buy the games, but mostly, because if they buy the game, they can always refund it. There's not really any excuse now. Your whole... I'm here for quality control is really out the window with the refund system. Because now anybody can buy the game, and if they don't like it, they can just refund it. They don't really need you anymore. But...
I'm not too worried.
I'm sure you're not. You make $10,000 a month on your Patreon site.
Patreon.
Whatever. You nitpick, but you have no good points. Are we done?
Unless there's anything else you'd like to say. I mean, I'll tell you this. Like, I'll ask you, and this is an absolute, I guarantee this is an absolute, good faith. What is it you'd like me to do with regards to coverage of games?
What would I like? I already told you, like, multiple times, and you... It's very simple. Be respectful. It's if you don't... If you come across as an asshole, you guys are spoiled. You guys are used to coming across as assholes to AAA companies, and they have the whole corporate theme, well, they'll blow smoke up your ass and be like, oh, you know, we'll get right on top of that, even though they have no intention of ever fixing
That's
it.
That's actually not true. I don't know if you've ever heard of the dealings I've had with various AAA companies that have gone similar ways to my dealings with you. So that's not true. You can't pretend that I get off scot-free by talking about AAA companies.
Okay. Whatever. Anyways, I forget what I was talking about because you interrupted me. Hey, do we got anything else? Oh, you wanted to know what I wanted you to do. Just be respectful. If you have criticism, totally cool. If there's a bunch of broke stuff with my game, shoot, have anybody you want, send me an email and I'll fix those problems. If there's something else that's wrong, if I can't get to it, I'll let you guys know. I'm not going to say it's going to be fixed if it's not going to be fixed, but at least you'll have some idea of, we'll have collaboration rather than you just attacking and not really having any purpose.
Okay. I've made it quite clear in the past that I don't agree with collaborating with developers. That I'm actively criticizing actively covering at the time, just because that's a conflict of interest. What I can tell you is that despite whatever you may think of me, however malicious you may feel I am longing and looking forward to the day when I can play a Digital Homicide game and say, you know what, this is pretty damn good.
Well, our games are getting better, so...
Well, I hope to see that day, because I tell you this, if I play one of your games and I genuinely think it's good, I will let people know. I've extended that to several developers in the past who've had things, with Gearbox Software being one of them. You know, I've had very bitter engagements with them over the years over various games of theirs, but when a good game of theirs comes along, I will treat it with the respect it's due.
You know, that would be great. You know, like I said earlier, I already admitted on the Slaughtering Grounds post that my initial video was an overreaction, which was why I took it down. You've carried this thing on and on and on, but I accept your apology, and I apologize for that video. I didn't mean to make it a personal attack. I was trying to attack your work, like you attacked my work, and maybe I failed at doing that, so I apologize.
Fair enough.
Alright, so now that we have an apology from each of us, we've each spoken our piece, I think that's a good end.
Okay. Well, I look forward to your next game.
Alright, look forward to your next video on somebody else's game.
Sure thing.
Alright.
Alright.
Hi, Jim. This is Jim.
Yep.
How do I do?